Hey everyone, it's me, Doom Link. Welcome to Let's Play, God Forbid, Dark Souls 2. Anyway, yes, I don't know why I'm playing this game. You would have a better idea as to why I'm playing this game than I do, to be honest. But yeah, I picked up that item. Yeah, I picked up that item over there. That's why there's no item there. Don't freak out. Don't attack the guys in here, because you will get annihilated. And yeah, anyway, let us now continue on. My mouth feels weird. I'm deprived of food. And yeah, anyway, whilst I'm starving and killing myself intentionally, I'm going to play this game, and this will be an important step towards the killing of myself. So yeah, anyway, you can't kill yourself, you cannot commit suicide without playing this game at least once. So we're going to do that now. Okay, 4 please, thank you very much, and we're going to go and pick up this item over here, thank you, small and silky stone. Okay, I haven't played through this game in quite a while, so I don't really know what to expect here. I'm probably going to play really bloody badly, but that's okay. Generally because, funnily enough, I'm not really used to the sluggishness of this game's combat system. It's total garbage. Ugh. It makes you feel dirty while you're playing it, because the combat system is just really slow. It's not pleasant at all. So basically, yeah, I don't really know what to expect. And I don't know what you should expect. I don't know what I should expect. I don't know what anyone should expect. So, we're going to see how we go. There's some loud noises outside, but this is good timing, because I'm going to go and deal with all this class building shit, so give me a second. You know what? That's good enough. Okay, I'll show you her face, and it's not that amazing. Anyway, let's go with this. I'm okay with this. Chose bonfire aesthetic, chose warrior, all this shit. Yeah, finalized creation. I haven't done warrior before. Basically, every single time I've done this, I've either chosen wanderer or sorcerer. And sorcerer is garbage, so don't choose sorcerer. Anyway, why is this music still playing? Shut up. Shut up. Anyway, broken sword, not a good weapon. Use something different. Why is there more loud noises happening? Anyway, yes, I'm going to use one of these weapons that I got from the DLC. Might as well use this, seeing as though it scales with strength, I guess. I think I have decent strength. 15 strength, yeah. Okay, so we will use that. In terms of how much this can block, is there anything better? This blocks more physical, so we will use this. Very well. Okay, this is another one of those DLC weapons. It's not like unique to the DLC, it's just not... I keep saying DLC, what's wrong with me? It's not even downloadable. I don't think it's something that you download. It's, sorry, I've been calling it DLC, what's wrong with me? I don't have any DLC for this game. What I meant to say was that it is from... is this the right way to go? Yes, okay, sorry. I just needed to kind of make sure that that was the way I was going. But what I actually meant to say was that this is from the pre-order edition, the Black Armor edition of Dark Souls 2. Which I got pre-ordered. Obviously, pre-order edition. I pre-ordered it. So, yeah, basically, this weapon here is going to be pretty strong, I guess, to start off here. 130 damage compared to whatever the broken sword was. Let's have a look and see what the broken sword was. Let's have a look, shall we? It was 100. Not a huge increase, actually, but you know what? It's better than nothing. Battery for controller 1 is running low. Sad news to hear that. Anyway, sad news to hear that? Anyway, hearing that is sad news, I should say. That was terrible. I didn't intend to attack an extra time there, but yeah, I remember last time my controller ran out of charge, it was just before I got to the False King in Demon's Souls when I was playing that. I can't remember which build that was. Was that... I think it was new game in my magic build in Demon's Souls. That wasn't good at all. I wasn't impressed with that situation at all, so... Yeah, basically, I hope I remember to go and plug my controller in. It's not really a position... Well, I'm not really in a position to go and plug it in right now, so I'm not going to. Usually the controller lasts for like 2 hours until it dies, once it tells you, oh yeah, by the way, it's low on charge. So, yeah, we should be okay for now. Going to shield this. I think, in general, we just... shielded basically all of that damage, which is good. Anyway, I'm going to try and not talk about how much I dislike this game as I'm doing this playthrough, because I would imagine that the people who are watching this Let's Play, if you're not watching it just because it's on my channel, you probably like this game. So I'm not going to basically tear this game a new hole while I'm talking to you here, because you don't want to hear me tearing it a new hole. You're not interested in me talking about that stuff. You're interested in me just playing the game and shutting up. So how about I do that? Anyway. Can you stop hitting me and shit? I would love it if you stopped doing that. Anyway, you know what? Generally, I go and deal with this guy first. That's something that I do every time, so I don't know why I'm not doing that right now. Can you stop? Anyway, let's say anyway a few more times and stutter on our words. Sounds like a good idea. Anyway. Yeah, and I say anyway again. That's just a habit of mine. I'm sorry, everyone. If you're concerned by the fact that I'm repeatedly saying anyway, then that's just something you're going to have to deal with when it comes to me. And I'm sorry if you can hear elephants above my head, because I do live beneath an elephant enclosure, in case you didn't know from my previous videos that I have made. Yes, that is a newly established fact for my videos. I do live beneath an elephant enclosure, and sometimes noises happen. And there's not much I can do about that. I tried to parry that. Didn't really happen, unfortunately. Something that I'm not a huge fan about when it comes to this weapon is the fact that it uses quite a lot of stamina when you attack with the weapons. So, I mean, I don't know. I guess there's not much you can do about it. It's one of those strength scaling weapons. Almost fell off there. I really don't like the whole press L3 to jump thing. I really am not a fan of that, because I feel that I just end up going off target every single time, so it's really not a pleasant experience to use that. Well, it's not like it's an unpleasant experience necessarily, but I don't like doing that because I feel that I'm constantly getting myself killed, and it's frustrating. Anyway, yes, roll through doors when you're opening them in this game makes things a lot faster. I'm not going to bother healing for the rest of, well, not for the rest of this, I mean, like, I'm not going to bother healing during this process, because this is the first area that we're going through. Stop with the bashing and crashing, the elephants are getting excited, it's dinner time, I don't know what's going on. Anyway, well, I do know what's going on, I just mentioned to you what's going on, it's dinner time for the elephants, and they are getting very excited. Anyway, let's shield again. Well, you know what, we don't even need to, let's just do that, and we'll go and kick this while targeting you. We only need to do the kick animation, then we're fine, then we don't have to worry about that anymore. Now we'll go and kill you. I'd like to kind of kill you a bit faster than requiring 3 hits to do so, because, I don't know, I feel like I want more power. Anyway, I'm going to use this and then fall down at the same time. And, wow, okay, so it seems that the amount of damage I'm taking there is a lot more than I first suspected. Okay, that's just not a good situation for me, so I'm going to go and backstab you now. I'm not happy at all. So I'm just going to go and fucking kill you, because you have gotten on my nerves, and I'm going to quickly go up here, and okay, well, I did end up getting hit by that. Makes me upset. Makes me upset. Makes me sad as well. In fact, I am upset that you hit me there. Anyway, yeah, I'm not really going through this area too particularly well. You are going to have to excuse me, because ultimately, this is the first time that I've played through this game in a really long time, so yeah, you're lucky that I'm being as quick about things as I am right now, so yeah. Oh, the elephants are getting excited again. You guys probably can't hear it, but yeah, if you do end up hearing something at some point in time, like off in the distance, don't be too surprised, because yeah, when you do live beneath an elephant enclosure, you do generally hear things like anyway, so we are now going to head off to Majula. Made a reasonably short work of that, it's only 13 minutes. If you do go through there rather slowly, it does kind of take a lot of time, so just try and get through that area nice and quick, really, because you don't want to be wasting too much of your time, if I'm being honest, so yeah, make short work of it. You will be thanking yourself later. Now, we are going to head over here. You know what, we'll go and pick up this item over here as well. Why not? Let's go over here, pick this up, Divine Blessing, something that I will never find the occasion to use, but you know what, doesn't matter. I'm not too terribly opposed to having a certain form of healing item. Of course, dropping down places in this game is much more enjoyable than in Demon's Souls. In Demon's Souls, you're like about to have a heart attack and you want to like, you don't even know what to do, you're just freaking out every single time you go to drop anywhere in Demon's Souls, but in this game and in Dark Souls you just kind of feel a little bit more comfortable about that process, because it's not horrifically flawed like it is in Demon's Souls. I mean, there are a lot of great things about Demon's Souls, and there are also a few strange things about it. Anyway, of course, the text in this game is fucked, in case you wanted to know. If you compare it to the previous two Souls games, it's just broken. It doesn't flow well at all. Like, you can't skip through it, and if you leave it alone, It takes forever to go to the next word, or the next sentence, I should say. It's really not nice. They fucked the text up really bad in this game. But anyway, not like the text itself, but like the dialogue, I should say. That would make more sense. So anyway, we are going to light this bonfire here. I actually don't have that many souls. What's the deal with that? I think I might have some... I hope I have some hard souls to consume. Yeah, I have literally 2 soul. Can we go over there, please? Thank you. Go use this other one. That'll give us a few souls. Why don't we have many souls at all? That's like not as many as I was hoping. But anyway, what we're going to do here is we are going to travel to Majula. Why? I'm going to tell you why. Because this stupid woman over here is someone that we need to ask to help us level up. Kind of similar to that of the Lady in Black. That's right. That's her name. I was about to call her the Woman in Black. Well, Lady, Woman, doesn't matter. Means the same thing. Slight differences, but anyway, she doesn't look that much like a lady. She's a bit creepy, but anyway, yeah, Lady in Black, you have to, like, actually go to a woman who is near where you kind of hang around and talk to her to level up instead of doing it through the bonfire like you did in the previous game. Where are you? Oh, you're over there. Jesus Christ. Anyway, she's just checking out the view, you know. Of course, we have to, yeah, and she wants to have a bit of a chat, you know, before she actually gives us a chance to level up. She is so rude. It's like she doesn't want us to level up. First of all, they make it really obscure to level up, and then, you know, you talk to her twice and she doesn't do anything. How easy would it be to just go, oh, okay, that's it then, and just keep on walking? It's not that hard to do that. Anyway, I'm going to double check to see the requirements for this morning star that I just picked up. Oh, we can use it now, it seems. Okay, well, we'll go and use that now then. It doesn't have as good of a scaling, but it does have more damage in general. So, as in base damage, as a weapon. So, it has a C scaling in strength, so... I don't really know what we want to do in this game, to be honest. In terms of our build, I don't really know what we want to do. I have a feeling that we might want to do strength. I have a feeling that we might want to do a lot of things, but I really can't tell you what I feel like doing. Like... and be definite about it, like, be diplomatic and say, I'm doing this, like, I don't know. So, I think just to start off with, I will level up something that is not relating to strength or dexterity or anything like that, and I think that's going to be endurance, you know, because I'm good with it. There we go. I was a bit confused, I was like, how do I level up? It's, yeah, it's different than Demon Souls Doomlink. Anyway, so yeah, come on. Don't waste me time. Anyway, so what we're going to do now is, I guess we'll go and head over here. Go and pick up this item. Yeah, everything about this game feels weird. It doesn't feel comfortable. I don't know. I go into Dark Souls and it's great. I go into Demon Souls and it's great. But this game, as soon as I go into it, it's like, ugh, I just want to get out. I'm not going to go into details about it, sorry. Because ultimately I said before that I wasn't going to talk about it. I wasn't going to talk about the fact that I dislike this game. I don't need to tell you guys that anymore. I've said that enough outside of this Let's Play, so I'm not going to say it anymore. Anyway, it's been an opinion that I've held since like the first month of having played this game, to be honest. I mean, kind of the further along I went through playing it, the less I liked it, you know. So, I wasn't, like, immediately hating it, but I did immediately notice that it didn't really catch on in the same way that Dark Souls did for me. And Demon Souls, of course. But anyway, once again, not going to get into it. Let us now continue on, and I don't know if it's just me, but, like, I have a feeling that everything that I do in regards to my stamina, that was getting dodgy there. I almost fell. I would not be impressed if I had already... if I were to already die at this point in the game, I would probably feel very... I would probably feel that I had failed immensely in my task to play this game to a reasonable degree of satisfaction. Or at least to... in a way that didn't make me look like a terrible player, you know? Anyway, let's go and pick up this. I think this is human effigy, if I remember correctly. Yes, I don't know how the hell I managed to remember that. I have forgotten most of the stuff in this game, to be honest. Seriously, my knowledge of Demon Souls and Dark Souls, in terms of just playing the game, just how comfortable I am with playing those two games, I'm far more comfortable playing them compared to this. This just feels very, very bizarre. Like, it's not... this game is not my home. Those other two games really feel like home, but this does not feel homely at all. This feels like some foreign experience that I shouldn't be having. It's weird. You are trying to get my attention. Come on, talk to me. Come and talk to me. Roll out of the way. He still managed to hit me there. Not too impressed about that. Anyway, I would like to hit both of you. There we go. And I didn't even intend to attack the second time there, but you know what? Doesn't matter. Let's go and rest at this bonfire here, shall we? Nice plan. I think that would be a good thing to do. Let's go rest here, heal ourselves up, and then continue on. I could have gone and joined a covenant if I wanted to, but I didn't really want to, so I didn't. It's kind of I'm not going to say it's a useless covenant, I just don't know what it does. Like, there's a covenant in Majula, and I don't really know what its purpose is. I've never really bothered offering it anything, I don't know, it's weird, I just don't bother with it at all, so I will continue to not bother with it, because my previous self determined that there was no point in doing so, so I will trust my past self for making that decision. Oh, you are still alive, what is the deal with you? Just die, come on. Let's try out the strong attack, which was not actually a good thing for me to try out, because that did damage and such, because I thought that it would do something like give me additional range, but it didn't really work out for me there. Anyway, cool. So, basically, there are going to be some dodgy enemies hanging around here that, you know, I can't really tell what's going on with your attacks, because you're very confusing. Like, just in terms of the animation of your bow, it's weird. It's very subtle from a distance. You can't really tell what's going on. But basically, there's an item down there, and I know of this because this has gotten me quite a few times. Don't run in there, because he turns up out of nowhere. I still don't know where he comes from. Next time I go down there, I should honestly check to see where the hell he comes from. He just appears, right? And he will trap you in there if you're not careful. I mean, look, this is not exactly a big space to be doing battle in, so to be honest, I would recommend that you kill him before you go in there, so, yeah. Anyway, there are going to be some enemies further up here, and I'm not very excited about fighting them. It's a bit of a crazy house, so just be aware of that. And unfortunately, the enemies in this game are very, very aggressive. They like to run after you and stuff, and it upsets me a bit. Something that I'm not a huge fan of in this game, well, there are two things. To start with, you know, the slowness of healing. To start with, I mean, you're healing really slowly, and you can see this enemy is just, like, seriously after my ass right now. And I don't really like that about some things. You know what? I totally mistimed that. That's my fault. What are you doing? There are too many enemies around here, right? And they're all running around. They're all so excited about something. I don't know what they're excited about, but it's something. And, you know, I'm not exactly rolling in stamina right now. I really should kind of upgrade my stamina a little bit. And you know what? I just can't do anything right now. I can do things, but it's just, it's all... I need to go and heal quickly. And roll, come on. It's like running a fucking zombie train through here. No! Stop. Just be consistent with your movements, please. I'm not trying to ask for too much. I'm just trying to ask for a little bit of help from you, my friends. That archer, by the way, is not very friendly. He's kind of after us right now, so we just need to... Would like to hit both of you. Oh, come on. How did I not even flinch this guy enough to, like, stop him from attacking for a short amount of time? That's all I wanted. Just a short amount of time without him attacking. That's all I was asking for. The range of this weapon is not incredible, if you haven't already noticed, but it is rather strong. Which helps. Let's attack. Stop walking away! This guy doesn't know what he's actually doing, and it's frustrating me. Don't suddenly speed up your attacks. This is really difficult, I have to say, because, you know, they are so... These enemies are really inconsistent, and I'm not entirely that into it. I'm not really liking these enemies very much at all. They're kind of bullshit, they're just doing dumb shit, and I didn't even intend to do a third attack there. That's one thing that's always annoyed me about the Soul series, you know, you do an extra attack when you didn't mean to, because you mash the button 3 times when you... Anyway, stop! Anyway, let me say anyway a few more 1,000 times, okay? Just need to be careful with this guy. Yeah, you can't even roll through arrows, really. I've tried it, it doesn't really work. Anyway, okay, pick up item, bandit's knife, another one of those, I'm good with that. Just jump over here, get an item. thank you, short thought, and something else that I wasn't actually looking at. And I almost did something bad, which involved me falling and possibly killing myself. Yeah, falling damage in this game, actually, and that was something that really kind of really pissed me off when I first came into this game considerably, was the amount of falling damage that exists compared to that of Dark Souls. And, well, I can't really... Yeah, Demon Souls as well. I mean, Demon Souls had a really sharp cutoff where you just died if you fell from a certain distance, but Dark Souls and Demon Souls in general had rather low damage for falling, but in this game, falling damage is just stupid, like, you... Yeah.